But usually the pain starts to get better from the 2 week mark, and I think the maximum effect is at about a 6 week mark.
You know, we've talked about PRP and APS. What if the patient needs surgery? What if you find an ulcer in the cartilage?
Yeah, so that would be a more advanced stage of injury of the cartilage. And so cartilage is a very unique kind of structure in the body that doesn't regrow or regenerate by itself. It needs to be stimulated. And after the stimulation, a few factors need to be present before a regrowth or a regeneration of the cartilage can be expected. So the traditional way that we use to treat cartilage ulcers is by stimulating the lesion. We poke holes into the
microfracture.
We poke holes into the bone and allow the bone marrow to float to the surface together with the stem cells. Then the stem cells will populate the cartilage, the hole, and over a period of time, hopefully the blood clot with the stem cells changes into fibrocartilage. Some obvious problems with that: if the hole, the ulcer is too large, sometimes the clot is unable to fill up the entire hole, or it gets dislodged very easily. So if the cartilage clot is dislodged, or the stem cell clot is dislodged, then certainly the capacity to regenerate is not going to be that good. And also with that, the concentration of cells is also important. If the mesenchymal stem cell clot contains very few stem cells, then of course the cartilage regrowth may not be as good. So as a person ages, the potential for regrowth is not as good as if you are a young person trying to do a cartilage repair procedure.
Of course. Yeah. So that brings us to the topic of BMAC, bone marrow aspirate concentrate. Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, that seems to be like a good way of basically giving the whole procedure a punch with increased stem cells.
That's right.
What are your thoughts on BMAC?
So BMAC was originally used to treat non-unions or fractures. So what happens is that we aspirate the bone marrow from a place which is very rich in bone marrow, like the hip bone or the iliac crest, and then we mix it around with the bone graft, and we place it in an area where there is a problem in the bone uniting. The bone marrow contains within itself a lot of growth factors. It contains stem cells. It also contains factors that induce healing. And it's been shown that it improves the union rate of fractured bones. So, I mean, as intelligent scientists and orthopedic surgeons, people have postulated that this could possibly help other ways of treating cartilage injuries by mixing it together with the mesenchymal stem cell clot that is used to treat used to regenerate cartilage. So the question is, how are we going to put these cells, this aspirate, into that cartilage ulcer? And that's a way that we can, or the way that we can do it is we can incorporate it into a scaffold, and we can put the scaffold onto the
cartilage. You need to hold the system together. Yeah.
That's right. So before we do that, actually the stage before that was this thing called AMIC, or Autologous Matrix Induced Chondrogenesis. So that's a mouthful, but basically what it means is that an applied scaffold is placed onto the cartilage ulcer, and the scaffold basically forms a biochamber. It traps the cells that are coming from the bone marrow up onto the ulcer, and it basically allows a super clot to form.
And this super clot is vital, of course, for forming new cartilage. Yeah.
Yes.
Hopefully good cartilage.
Yes. So the more stable the clot is, and the longer it remains there with a high cell density, the theory is that the higher chance it can grow into good cartilage.
Okay, so what do you think of those cases where, you know, you do a scan and you see that ulcer, and you also see this huge change in the bone marrow?